is angry. Is that a smallmouth?
That bickery is fighting so hard.
That's good. I got a pair of pliers here if you need them. Because I'm not one to try to take a treble hook to the finger. I'll use pliers in a heartbeat. Lost my battery in the kayak. Phone, wallet, keys, identity card. Wasn't the most graceful entrance, but hey, we're in it. So the fish finder is going to be pointless today, but that's okay. It is A-okay. I'll get under there. Guess for right now, we're all right. Let me take his jacket off real quick, so I'll be right back. Thank you. was lucky.
Not to do. Thank you.
like, look, I'm gonna give y'all a heads up. Do an extra good job.
Oh, man.
Oh, no, I got it. I appreciate it. I've got it finally down pat and all this fun stuff. What did you come up with that design?
I did. I looked at it one day, and my dad, he was looking at it, trying to figure something out for me. I was like, well, I've got some 3-inch PVC pipe. And it sat right on it. And all I did was throw it up there and kind of look. And I put my, I had some pieces of PVC pipe that went through my scuffer holes here. Yeah. And I looked down through them after I sat them down and looked up under it and seen kind of where they would be at. I just lined it up with those and screwed everything down and it worked good. So it surprised me. I didn't have to adjust it much at all. Once I screwed down the 2x6s, I did the PVC the PVC through the scupper hole, let it sit down there, kind of looked at it. I screwed the PVC pipe down once and that was it. And it sat right on it.
You ought to do a video up on YouTube with that.
Yeah, I need to.
Unless you want to.
I got a couple. That's what I told my wife. I thought about just trying to find them, make them, but there's so many different trailers that. Because every one of these are shaped different. And yeah. All that fun stuff. I was at Chester Frost. We camped there one year. And I was like, where's the closest bait shop? And I got on my phone and looked up bait shops. It said Jack's Bait and Tackle. I said, no, it's down near Amnicola. And I got to look. It was 5 minutes from Chester Frost if you took the water.
Yeah.
It was 45 if you drove.
Golly.
That's ridiculous.
It is.
That's a long way around.
Yeah.
Like I tell everybody, you know, if I plan to go somewhere, I try to make it where I want to go. If I go to here and I want to go to, you know, Chester Frost, something like that, I'm not doing it this. Even on the boat, it's still a, you know, 10-minute drive roughly. But I really got to figure everything out because I live in Cleveland. So if I'm going to Hickson, I'm not going to stop by Harrison. If I'm going to Harrison, I'm not going to Hickson. So, but I do. I fish around here a lot. Normally, here recently, I've been fishing at Skull Island, but I'll come back over this way.
We've got some.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna get back to Cleveland, get me something to eat on my way back. Been up since about 5:30 this morning, and I dropped my little girl off at 7 to go to school, and then I come straight out here.
You make it to retirement. Don't worry about having anything to do.
I've heard that more than once. That's how my grandmother was. I'm like, my goodness. So you work all your life just to have to go to the doctor all the time.
Yeah, I'm not going to work anymore. Yeah. I'm going to go relax. I'm going to be running around a lot.
You thought you'd get to relax. That was just a thought.
But I'm just glad to be here, buddy.
You're exactly right. You have a good one. Be careful.